All right, in this episode, we're going to talk about how to embed an expanding Excel range in Word with live updates. This question from Ashley, who was in my seminar at UCF a week and a half ago. Ashley has a bunch of Excel ranges that she needs to get into Word. And the problem is the data in the range is changing, like increasing the number of rows, and it's not being picked up. So here's the set of steps that I found that successfully will do this. The goal here is to get this entire range in Excel. And this range even points to things that are outside of the range, like that formula there, you know. But I don't want this column or that column to show up. So what I found is select the range, go to Page Layout, Print Area, Set Print Area. Of course, make sure that the file is saved. It has to be saved, you know, with a path and file name. And then copy that entire area. Control C. We'll switch over to Word. And so this is a test. And then right here, I will paste Control V. But you have to come here to this little drop down and choose the third item over, which is link, but keep the source formatting. Click OK. All right, now this has also been saved. I'll save it again. All right, and then the big test, can we insert more rows and maybe even change the numbers outside of the range and have that formula update? So we'll switch back to Excel and I'll just insert a few rows here. Extra. And then out here, currently I have 17. We will change some of these numbers. Let's see, why did this formula not change? Because I didn't include it in the range. And then just add a little bit of color out here, home. All right, good. So all of those changes happened. I haven't even saved the file yet. If I go back, amazingly, I guess because they're both open, that number 29 has changed, the 11 has changed, the yellow has changed. It increased in size, so that's all great. It's a little frustrating that we had to follow these steps. Ashley is convinced that in the past she's done something like this. I'm going to switch over to another workbook here. Okay, so this is called 2601 Just One Sheet. It has just one sheet, no named ranges. We currently have 17 as the formula. I'll save that. And then in Word, I'll do Insert, Object, Create from File, Browse, 2601 Just One Sheet, Link to File, changes to the source file will be reflected in your document, right? But they included columns that I didn't want included. So, and we're already truncating stuff at the bottom of the worksheet. I'll undo, come back and see if setting the print range makes a difference. Page Layout, Print Area, Set Print Area, Control S to save, and then Insert, Object, Create from File, Just One Sheet, Link to File, click OK. Yeah, like it doesn't respect the print range at all. So it's so strange that just doing a copy and then a paste changing to keep source formatting will correctly set up the link and it grows, but doing insert object does not. If you're watching this video and you're an expert in this and you know some bulletproof way to do this other than the copy and paste method, you know, maybe there's some secret hidden setting somewhere. Please, down in the YouTube comments, make sure to let me know. Well, hey, I want to thank Ashley for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.